We're excited. You know, the coach had been excited all along, and when I had a chance to go over and see him, and one, you know, he's playing for a terrific program. You know, I remember his high school coach, Keith Gatlin, from, you know, terrific player at Maryland, and, you know, really one of the first, you know, when I got into coaching, big point guards, and so he's coming out of a great program, and extremely athletic. And the last time I saw him play, I was really impressed with his last workout that I saw, because I don't know if he missed a shot the entire time, and he's bouncy, and I really enjoyed sitting and talking to him about the questions that he asked. I mean, it wasn't the generic questions that you would expect. I mean, just really talking about, you know, development, how we could develop him, and I asked him some pretty tough questions, and I really appreciated his honesty and the way he answered those questions, and we all know that he needs to get stronger, which he will. But we've coached so many guys like him. You got to remember, we coached a guy that everybody questioned how strong he was, and ended up being a pretty good player. And Kevin Durant, you know, people made fun of him that he couldn't bench press 185 pounds. Not that I'm comparing Jalen to Kevin, but in terms of what you learn when you're dealing with young people like this, you got to try to project where they'll be with their bodies physically, and we've got a lot of confidence in what we do here with our strength conditioning program, and that part of it, we think he's going to be fine. And so we think he's a big get for us.
Are you going to make any changes to the starting lineup for Friday?
No, I mean, no. Well, obviously, after the other night, you know, we're trying to play around a lot of different lineups in case, you know, you got to expect some foul trouble here or there, and trying to get different combinations together. And but in terms of who will start, I'd be hard-pressed to remember who all really started the other night, but the fact is we'll make that decision probably Thursday sometime.
And you touched on it Monday. When Armani and Kevin, if they're not on the floor together at the time, do you have any, you know, kind of clues about what you might do? I think it's pretty stagnant without them.
Well, that's kind of where we have addressed some of those issues and how we think we can play with a different group of guys. And what we were more disappointed in was not so much offensively, but what we did on the defensive end. You know, we just didn't guard. And, again, you're playing against a team that's well-coached, and they know what they're doing. And if you don't guard, they can make you look real silly. And they did at times, because we just didn't protect our goal. But the fact is, we know we can defend. We had defended better than we did the other night, but we spent this past couple of days, and we'll get back at it today, working on defense, because we've got to be much better than we were the other night.
You talked about when you first took this job being from Hickory and having come here several times when you were in college and stuff. Just your background with this place, familiarity with the location, how much has that helped? How much did it make you, does the job appeal to you?
Well, I think when you think about the location, it's, you know, when you have been in Texas as long as I've been there, you know, you go 4 hours in that state, you haven't left the state. And, you know, you normally get to Dallas and Houston, and, you know, obviously San Antonio is closer, but here, you cover a lot of ground within 4 hours, you know, and some really, there's always been great basketball in this area. You know, I think you go back and you look at the history of college basketball, you know, the East has always been considered a hotbed in some ways, and you look at, you know, what goes on at Kentucky and their success, but then you look over, you know, to the East and the ACC, and there's a real emphasis on basketball, I think, east of the Mississippi. I really believe that, and I grew up with it. And so we've been able to get into a lot of different places recruiting, and we obviously know this state's going to produce some talent close enough to Atlanta, where that's got to be a hot area for us, to Carolina. So, and we're going to go east. And there's no doubt we're going to go east, and we already, you know, we're going to go really wherever we have to go. But you can get to a lot of different places from here.
Any word on Ray? Can he still play while you guys are trying to?
No, we're still in the hands of our compliance. I don't think there's any question they're getting closer, but when and all it will happen, we don't.
Will he be able to play without Rooley like he did in the exhibition game, or is it changed?
No, he was clear for that exhibition game and only the exhibition.
But there's still a chance.
I think I mentioned last time we were together that we could get. Like, that call came in, I think, at 5 o'clock, the day of the exhibition game. And they actually called me and said he's eligible, so we ran some people down and said, hey, we got to get him his uniform. And so that's the way it works.
How did Jabari respond to, you know, the discipline that you threw out on him? I'm sure it was probably disappointing.
Well, I mean, that's a good word, disappointing. I mean, we're all disappointed. And, you know, he was, you know, 5-6 minutes late for it. And the fact is, and he stepped up and he said, you know, I don't have an excuse, you know. But he's got to realize, you know, that can't happen. And I think it'll be something I don't think he'll be late anymore. If he does, I'm going to start questioning some other things about him. But the fact is, it's something that, you know, again, he took full responsibility, and I don't know if he knew that was going to happen, but there was no doubt we weren't going to play him.
And Kyle, how valuable would it be to get a game like that on the field, no matter who you're playing, just to go back and show him, you know, this is what we're talking about in practice?
Yeah, it is. I think it's really valuable. Anytime you can get film on these guys, and that's what I've been doing in there. You know, I love to be in Pratt and watch a lot of tape there myself, and it really is amazing how many guys are asking me about watching tape with them. Because I think they do learn a lot from it, and I think they know that I enjoy watching tape, and you know, we're going to get in the film room with them and show them some things, but the fact is a lot of them are wanting to watch more on their own, which is a good thing.
Rick, how important is this? I think there's 4 games in 9 days when you're trying to, when everything's so new and you're trying to get new schemes in there. How important is it, a stretch like that where you're playing a lot of basketball?
Well, they're all important. I mean, I think every game's important, and I've always told our teams, and we'll tell them, obviously, this team the same way. I mean, if you don't think every one of these games are important, wait come March. And every game's important. And I think we all know now, you look at what happens when you get to talking about postseason and wanting to be a postseason team. And, you know, you look back and they talk about good losses, bad losses, and good wins, bad wins, or I mean, bad losses. So they're all big. And when you're trying to put together a scheme like we are, we've got some things in, but there's certain things we have to be really good at. Mm-hmm. And that's what we didn't do the other night. The group that was in there when we struggled, they just didn't execute the things that they should execute. And that's what they have to do. I mean, we have to be a team that executes. And it was simple breakdowns where guys not doing some of the things that we've talked about from day one, just getting to the corner, you know, space on the floor. We just did not fight for the space, and we didn't have to fight for it. We just stopped running where we were supposed to be. Those are the breakdowns you can't have. So I do think that here, when you're playing a lot of games right now, everybody's ready to play. There's no doubt. So it's going to give us a chance to play different teams. You're going to play against different styles.
Does it take games to really understand the good shot from great shot and stuff?
That's a great question. I think you're exactly right. I mean, understanding good from great, good to great. And I do think games do that. I think where they see it, and I do think the other night, what I do like about the other night, I think they were really excited about playing, and I think the adrenaline had a little bit to do with the fact that we cramped up, because we haven't done that all year.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing, because you want guys excited every night. I don't care what the situation is, who the opponent is. You want guys that are really, you know, just chomping at the bit to be ready to get out and compete.
That situation with Cassandra and waiting on all that news, is that, in the meantime, does that change things for guys like Hubs and guys who are bigger guards who could slide inside if they need to and things like
well,
that?
Well, we worked on, you know, and I mentioned the other night, we've got to get some things around the basket, and there's different ways to do it. You know, you can post guards, you can do some different things, and we will. But, you know, the way I've always been with, whether it's a situation with Ray's in or injuries, you know, you got to take what you got and go play, but with Robert, Robert's a really good inside player, and he's got to want to go in there and score. I mean, I think he's a guy that's more than capable of doing that, but it's up to us to get him in those situations. I think he likes doing that. I do. I think our guards like to do it too. And I think as the season goes on, we have basic things that we have to have in, but from those basic things, options will change based on what we see as we keep moving forward. But we're going to try to get a post game some way, somehow.
Well, Robert would be one of the only options, right, when you look at just size-wise?
No, not necessarily. I mean, I think you can post guards. I think guards can go in and post. I mean, I don't – you know, you get 2 points in there, whether it's the guy's 6'8", 6'9", or 5'10". So the point of the matter is you want to get in there and put pressure on the basket, around the basket, hopefully some foul shots, you know, get fouled for some thousand on some people and get to the free throw line.
You mentioned bringing back the, I guess, Snow's medal thing for players to run. What, why did you decide to kind of bring back some of these traditions from years past?
Well, now, when I came, the first time I really came here for an event, my wife's cousin, P.K. Buff, swam at Auburn for Eddie Reese, and they were having a conference swim meet, and it's the only swim meet I've ever been to in my life. And it was at, you know, the swim, the aquatic center. And I remember the swim team coming out through the tee, and I think they wore the coonskin hats, right? And that's what I remember. And I know, and I know that running through the tee is a big part of it. And actually, when I hear with John Ward was how it started in basketball. It started on the basketball court. You know, Ray Mears did it. I mean, that's where it started. And then after that, I think Coach Dickey and the band director got together and decided how they were going to do it on the football field. But running through the tee started with Ray Mears, and so I think it's a great thing to bring back. And like I said, I watched it live at the Aquatic Center back in '75.
Thanks, Kyle.